السلام عليكم حنان الله، سمعت بصراحة بان ترسمها زي نظم. هبت من ما تشارك ترسمه غلجة شهرية كناس نايا دبولمي من كناس نايا نا كيف أخطي لكم الدنان عشر جزا الله يرضي يتقن شايد بوش تمرت بيشم قد يستفيد لأيه Exactement. Moucho. Maintenant, je suis venu à l'Ukraine. Je suis venu à l'Ukraine pour cette période. Amérique, au comité de Rahmet. Moucho, je suis venu à l'Ukraine pour Rahmet. Rahmet est un peu plus de temps. Mais, je suis venu à l'Ukraine pour cette période. Je suis venu à l'Ukraine. Il est venu Maintenant, je suis venu à l'Ukraine pour cette période. Pour cette période. Rahmet.
Hello to all of you. My name is Tursunay Ziyawudun. I am from Kunes County, Gulja City, East Turkestan. I am speaking to you today as a survivor who spent time in a concentration camp in Kunes. Thank you to the US government for giving me this opportunity to tell you about my experience. I thank all of you. Because I do not know English, Ms. Elise is going to tell you about what happened to me. I feel that I must speak up as a survivor for all those who have not survived. I'm not asking for sympathy for myself. I am asking governments around the world to wake up. The world should not allow genocide to continue in the 21st century. I grew up in East Turkestan. My husband and I moved to Kazakhstan in 2010. The Kazakhstan government granted residency to my husband, who is of Kazakh ethnicity, but my application was rejected. Because my Chinese passport was expiring, I returned to my hometown in November 2016. Border officials questioned me. Why did I go to Kazakhstan? Had I been in contact with anyone from the US? 1 month later, the authorities confiscated our passports, and a few months after that, I was sent to a camp. The conditions were terrible and filthy. We were told we had problems with our ideology and would receive education. If we asked questions, we were beaten. Because of my health condition, I was released after around 1 month. The second time I was sent to a camp was far worse. It has left an unforgettable scar on my heart. I was taken on March 8th, 2018, and kept there for more than 10 months. Buses would arrive every day with more detainees. It was very overcrowded. There was a bucket in the corner for a toilet. There were cameras watching us inside the cell, and we were always hungry. Each meal was a watery soup and a bun. We were given injections of unknown medications. Every day, we had to endlessly swear loyalty to the Chinese government and reject our faith. We had to watch endless videos about Xi Jinping. Girls would be taken away and only brought back days later. I saw girls lose their sanity because of it. And then I myself was taken, along with another woman. I was tortured with an electric stick pushed inside my genital tract. I could hear the other woman's screams in the next room. I knew the guards were raping her. After that, she never stopped crying. One time an order came. All the women had to be sterilized or fitted with an IUD. Many young women were crying, screaming when they were told they would be sterilized and could never have children. I left the camp in December 2018. Before my release, the officials warned me. If I spoke about my experience, there would be heavy consequences. I still did not feel free. One day I saw a former cellmate. She had survived, but she was dead inside, completely finished by the rapes. The government's goal is to destroy everyone, and everybody knows it. In September 2019, I was allowed to leave for Kazakhstan. I told my story to a Kazakh human rights group and to journalists, but I was still afraid of the Chinese government. There was a suspicious fire at our house, and the Chinese police would call me and threaten me. It was only after I came to the US last year that I decided I could tell the full story of what happened to me. I knew that I might not be believed. I knew that some people would consider that my honor was tarnished. But with the support of my husband, I took my courage in my hands and told the truth to BBC reporters. The story was aired on February 2nd. The story sent a shockwave around the world, but Uyghurs and Kazakhs thanked me for speaking out. They couldn't stop their tears as they thought about their sisters and daughters and what they might be suffering. We cried together. The Chinese government reacted by smearing me and the other survivors who testified about sexual abuse, even a culture of rape in the camps. At a press conference in Beijing, the foreign ministry spokesman held up my photo and called me a liar. I want to thank the United States for giving me safe haven. Without your help, I would still be a stateless refugee, still fearing that the Chinese government could force me back to China. Now you have my testimony. I ask you to take action. Thank you.